Hello, sustainable growers. In this video, we'll see what is the biggest hazard for your fish in aquaponics. But before, please give me a like, share the video, and don't forget that you can have some bonus from the description of the video. Okay, so we hear a lot of things about aquaponics. What is dangerous for the fish? We hear some people who are scared about the neighbors who would spray something and it will finish into the aquaponics setup. It can be a problem, that's right. We hear people who think the fish are not going to have enough food. Most of the time, that's not a problem. Some people think they can kill the fish because they put too much food into the aquaponics setup. That's right. But do you know what is the number one hazard for your fish? The number one hazard is to have the electricity, the power, that shut down. Because in this case, your pump are not going to turn off. Basically, you are not going to have any recirculation of water, so no water drop, and also your air pump is going to turn off. And if it lasts for a while, that's going to be a major issue. It's like the black swan theory. People living in Europe were thinking that all the swans were white, you know. And they have never seen a black swan, so they just thought black swan don't exist. But traveling around, you realize that, yeah, black swan exists. They are not very popular. You don't have a lot of black swan in the world, but there are some. And that's the same thing with electricity problems. When you are in your house, you never have any problem with electricity, right? It's like 99% of the time electricity works. I mean, I'm talking about people who live in first world countries, such as Australia, Europe, North America, Canada. You know, we always have power at home. We always have electricity and we don't see it as an issue. So we put the setup in place, everything is working very well, no issue, we just plug it very quickly outside. But here we can have two problems. The first one is to have a power breakage, you know, like the city is turned down because there is a problem around, or they are just working on the line, whatever, so they cut the line for a few hours. It can happen, but that's not the biggest problem, because this, most of the time, it's only for 2 hours. So in an aquaponic setup, if you don't have too many fish, if you are not overpopulated, and depending on the species that you're going to grow, most of the time your fish are going to survive by 2 hours without any pump. There is enough oxygen into the fish tank by itself to allow your fish to survive for 2 hours. The problem would be the problem that is more common is people put the setup in place very quickly, and they plug the setup like with normal plugs, and it's outside, and one day it rains very heavily, it rains on the plug and creates basically a shortcut, and the power turns off in your house. And that's during the night, or that's during a time where you are on holiday, and that's when you come back and all your fish are dead, or the morning you wake up and everything is dead, because it lasts for like 6 hours without any power. So it's a very basic, you know, you just think about it, or go have a look in your setup. If you have an aquaponic setup running at the moment, go outside and check your connections, your electricity connections. There are some things that you really don't want to see, you know, the kind of connections that are adapted for being inside, they are not adapted to the rain, they are not adapted to the wind, they are not adapted to whatever can happen outside if you leave it on the soil. You know, an animal walk around, your dog walk around, just or even your kids, you know, they pull the cables and up, the power is off and your fish are gonna die. So that's the number one problem that you can have in aquaponics. It looks like a very stupid video, but believe me, if you don't check that, you have a lot of chance to one day lose your fish. So please check all your connections and make sure that they are waterproof. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please let me know in the comments if you think that's a good advice. and let me know how it is in your place. Are the cables really well adapted to be outside, or did you put it in place very quickly and you're gonna fix that? Let me know basically if this video was useful. If it's the case, please give me a like, and don't forget that you can have all our bonuses in the description of the video just below. Thank you for watching. Thank you so much for watching the video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.